them to the room where they escaped and all fled.
I asked to go to summer camp. They sent me to Aunt Dick's. She dressed some pretty cats. I think she's going crazy.
Oh!
Out here. Hashtag no texting for 2 weeks.
Are we there yet?
Will you please just settle down?
Every year we take this trip to spend some time together. We talk about the last 12 months and how things could have been better. Family time is precious when the kids grow up so fast.
So let's enjoy the drive
and reminisce about the past.
First day of school is always a challenge. The kids are so used to sleeping in past their alarm that it seems like nothing can wake them up.
If I don't catch the bus, then I'm gonna have to walk. I know I need the exercise, but it's like 60 blocks. 'Cause I've got the going back to high school blues. And I'm telling you, I don't wanna go back to school.
They're gonna weigh me down with books.
Show me a locker.
Going back to school.
when teenagers are unleashed on thine house for 2 months without a summer job. We've witnessed pestilence.
Who brings home a rat as a pet?
Latin.
You are taking Spanish, right? Not Latin.
drive. And ever so slightly, I want you to press on the gas and...
Okay, we'll just put that in the baby pile. wasting your time and your money. Something here that I want to wear is going to get shoved to the back of my closet. You'll never see it again.
But you need to wear some color. I don't like all this black.
Black is the absence of color.
That's what I'm talking about. It's so depressing.
Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing.
Ah.
William Shakespeare.
For every one of us that succeeds, it's because there is somebody there to show us the way out. Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah, totally in the same stratosphere as Willie.
Don't call Shakespeare Willie.
Oh, sorry, you're right. If he hears me, he might get offended if his body hadn't already been eaten by maggots 400 years ago.
I just think a little color would perk you up.
I'm perky. See?
Got something in here.
Hey, if it makes you feel any better, one time in art class, I mixed all the colors of paint together and it turned to black, so like technically, I'm a walking rainbow.
Rainbows do not hang crosses upside down above their beds.
I was just trying to freak you out.
Mission accomplished, young man. What about some overalls?
Oh, please don't get on my tractor. Oh, you know I love me some Sports Center.
But what about this turtle?
That can work. I love the garment. The design is slowly choking throughout the day.
Never mind. Your turtle life. What about this?
That's a prom dress. If you're trying to tell me that you want me to start wearing women's clothing instead of black.
No, no, I grabbed it by mistake.
I'm shopping, 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 shopping with mom. I'm trying, 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 trying to stay calm. But I know, I know, I know something's wrong when she displays a passion. Higher social status, picking my nose. Imagine.
How about this sailor suit? Look at it, just come on. Look at it.
If I wore that, I'd be sure to get beat up every day. I'm not sure you can afford that. What's our current copay? Imagine all the things my friends would say. I'd be a major failure dressing like a sailor.
How about this?
Hang on for a second, Jersey Shore, they just called. They took a look at that and even they were appalled. That knee is cut so deep it goes right down in my waist. I may as well wear nothing if I go by your taste.
What about this guy?
Well, let's add a little tutu, won't that be swell? It sends a subtle message that'll always live at home. I'm a mega wicked loser who is gonna die alone.
I just wanted to take your shopping. I guess that was a mistake. I can tell you don't want to spend time with me. I'll go just in a lake.
Could be hipper. because I went shopping with my mom.
No! I am not going to take any more smart aleck remarks from you.
No, I'm being totally serious. It matches our school colors. I can wear it on pep rally days. This is a great shirt.
You actually like it?
Yes, it's exactly what I want. Oh, it's a little bit expensive, though.
No, it's not. You like it? It's not black. We're buying it.
Man, that is one ugly shirt. But sometimes, you gotta let them win. And besides, I don't even have to wear it out the front door. Once I get on the bus, that hood is getting shoved in my backpack.
Sweetie, come here. I just found the most adorable pair of tennis shoes.
Here we go again.
Our nature. That which is created is meant to be destroyed.
What is that in the game?
It's from a video game.
Because we should all live our lives based on the wisdom of a video game.
Hey, video games often closely resemble the real world. You're just not open-minded enough to realize that art imitates life.
Yes. Let me just go jump over some barrels on my way to save a damsel in distress from a gorilla. Then I'll bash my head against some bricks to eat some mushrooms.
Exactly.
I just want to have a normal Thanksgiving at Alice's house.
You think I want to be here searching for medical waste in my dinner?
Enough! That is enough from the both of you. We are going to have a nice, normal family dinner for once, and we are going to enjoy each other's company on this blessed day, where so help me, you will all be grounded.
Even me?
Especially you.
The pasta.
What about you, Brittany? He's getting the pasta, then I'm getting the antipasta. I think it's actually pronounced. I know how it's pronounced. I was being contrarian.
Whoa now. We've talked about the four syllable words. I'm only a freshman.
I'm having eggplant parmesan. Just like the real pilgrim. Well, Columbus was Italian. Columbus wasn't at the first Thanksgiving.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty certain. Did you two even go to grade school?
Ooh, ooh. The Nina, the Pizza, and the Santa Maria.
Shut up, boy. So I'm here to have a dollar.
Thanks, Dad.
What is he doing?
I'm encouraging his learning.
I can't believe I'm related to you people. What's going on?
Oh, you know these old fancy restaurants. They like to dim the lights before they play the romantic music.
I can't even see my fork.
Why would you need your fork? They haven't even brought us any bread.
I got something stuck in my teeth, and I wanted to pick it out.
And I wonder why our dental bills are so high.
Give me a minute, though. The music will start playing. Whoa!
No singing!
I was just trying to set the mood.
Forget about setting the mood. I think they closed the restaurant.
You can't be serious.
We did have to seat ourselves.
And I had to grab some menus on the way in.
Come to think of it, I haven't seen a single waiter since we got here.
The sign did say open, didn't it? Didn't it?
Well, the lights were on.
Great. No turkey, no pasta. I'm gonna starve.
Says the girl who's constantly dieting.
Shut up!
You shut up!
Well, both of you, just shut! Just simmer down.
I'm gonna go see if I can't catch the chef in the parking lot. See if he won't rip us something.
And if not, we can always stop at 7-Eleven. They're always open.
Oh, goody. Slim Jims and Cheetos for Thanksgiving. That reminds me. We haven't yet said what we're thankful for. I'll go first. I'm thankful for my caring, loving, and understanding family. Who do you go next? I'm thankful that I'll be 18 soon, and I'm going to find a college as far away from this town as possible.
Well, I'm thankful for the dark, so I don't have to see my sister's stupid face.
That's enough! Father, what are you thankful for?
Locksmiths!
Well, that's interesting. What are you talking about?
Well, the doors are locked. I think we're trapped.
Everyone, stop talking! We've only got so much air!
We're not stuck in a spaceship! We're locked in a restaurant!
You're wasting more oxygen!
Everybody, calm down. Who has a cell phone? I do! It was in my book bag. In our former garage!
Mine's in the car.
Mine's dead. I wasted it downloading that picture of the ravioli.
Well, I guess we're going to have to break a window.
Hooray! I got this goal!
Security came down.
And here comes the
want to stay?
Climb on the roof, put up the lights, blow up the elves, there'll be delights. I will outdo that bum next door, soon you will see I can do more.
Climb
on the roof, put up the lights, blow up the elves, there'll be delights. I will outdo that bum next door, soon you will see I can do more.
Everybody at the senior center knows it's true that you've got to get the rap band. too busy to visit your Nana?
No, it's just...
I understand. Why would someone so young and alive want to spend time with a shriveled up old mummy?
Not that old, Grandma.
Chris?
Huh?
Your newspaper's upside down.
Oh my, you're right. Oh well, my vision's going. It's better off not even knowing this news. I've got one foot in green. I've got your shoulder soon enough.
Don't talk like that. It's depressing.
Hey, mister, pull my finger.
I'm good.
Hey, Missy.
I'd rather not.
Too late. I'm bad. By the way. mug and pop order.
Yeah, maybe $5 if we're lucky.
Yeah, that'll buy us a couple of records.
Yeah, true that, true that.
That was too close for comfort. How would you feel if they actually thought we were cool?
They'd want to hang out with us all the time.
Yeah, we can't have that. Let's kick it.
Was it grass?
Yeah.
Hey, what's that up ahead? It looks like intermission.
Can we stop?
No!
I made up more to let my kids stretch their legs, use the restroom more, buy some cookies. My sure as heck will hold you nice people hostage.
Help us!
So, we'll see in about 10 minutes.
If we haven't thrown ourselves from the vehicle.
That's why we have chatbots.
We'll see you in a bit. Oh, we're going on a camping trip. Camping trip. Camping trip.
Are we there yet?
I'm driving as fast as I can.
there yet.
Are we there yet? We haven't even left our county. I have to pee so bad.
I told you not to drink all that orange juice.
I was thirsty. Are we there now?
Yes, in the past 5 seconds, we have magically entered a wormhole and arrived at our destination. Grab your tent.
What's a wormhole? It sounds like some place you'd live.
How about you try putting down the fashion magazines and picking up a book sometime, moron? Ever heard of Stephen Hawking?
I don't like horror books.
Stephen King.
Well, I'm not a big fan of skateboarding either. Honey, Tony Hawk.
You've seriously never heard of Stephen Hawking.
You've seriously never heard of Shut Up or Out to the Mom about your commemorative plate of Princess Diana.
It broke during an earthquake.
Yes, yes it did.
Come to think of it, we don't even live near any fault lines.
Oh, look, that kid is mooning us.
Oh!
All right, come on, old friend, it's go time.
Whatever!
I know she doesn't mean to be short with them, but it seems like all they can do is talk about the bad memories, and trust me, Nana, you've gotten to the worst. But my kids really are quite lucky. Both my wife and myself's parents are still with us. They haven't even really been to a funeral. Well, except for Pete the parakeet, and that wasn't all that emotional until our neighbor's cat ran off with Pete's corpse and put it on our porch the next morning. I miss his head. But my wife's great aunt Lula died. It was time for my kids to deal with real grief.
Well, this is nice. Tom, where's the funeral parlor?
I think what your mother is trying to say is that your great aunt Lula loved flowers. And if she were here, she'd love to see all these beautiful floral arrangements.
Sweet, buckle up!
What are you doing?
Saving the world from the zombie apocalypse.
Have some respect.
But I don't even want to be here.
Me neither. Do you think Great Aunt Lula wants to be here? Do you? Now hush up.
Alrighty. So, what do we do now?
What kind of question is that?
Hang on, dear. I'm with our daughter on this one. I mean, I haven't exactly been to a funeral myself since I was a child. So, what exactly do we, do?
Well, we should probably find the funeral director.
It's a thing, Peter. What? I brought you breakfast.
Would you really want to eat food prepared by an electrician?
Good point. Can we hit up Mickey D's on the way home?
We just got here. Give it a rest and focus on why we're here.
Why are we here?
To pay our respects. It's what good family members do.
Explain to me again how we're related to Great Aunt Lula.
Well, she is my mother's sister.
You mean was? White, you always correct my grammar mistakes. Can I be excused from the table? I don't know. Can you? Are you capable of being excused? Or may I be excused?
Would you? White.
Anyways, you were saying she was your mother's mother.
Hang on. I thought she was my father's mother's sister.
Are you sure? I'm pretty sure she's from my side.
I've never met her, but I am almost positive she's from my side.
Wait. What if she's from both your sides? Not to mean that we're related. Enough!
Enough! We are not related. Things just get complicated when you come from a big family.
We're just not sure which side Baby Lula is from.
So then why are we here?
To pay our respects!
To a woman you've never even met? So basically, what you're telling me is I'm wasting valuable Sunday TV viewing time to pay my respects to a stranger?
She is not a stranger.
Oh, cool, I'll be casket!
Get back here!
Well, at least she's showing an interest. What?
Or what?
She was a Christian.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
But you never met her. You don't really know if she was? I mean, if she was an atheist or something when they were burying her in a special type of cemetery.
Why does it matter? You never want to come to church with us. Why are you so curious now?
I was just making conversation. She
Hey, Mom. Have you ever seen a picture of Great Aunt Lula?
Of course, we have one hanging in the hall with all the family photos.
I thought so. And in that picture, did she have an eye patch and a pair of impressive, well-groomed mutton chops?
Son, what are you trying to say?
And I know that fashion can change, but would she really be the kind of lady who would want to be buried in a black leather jacket with a motorcycle helmet tucked underneath her hands?
Oh my gosh, we're at the wrong wake!
Thank you for coming to Mama's Wake. The Bitter Spring Beastly Weaver Motorcycle Gang greatly appreciates your attendance. You know, we gotta stick together, brothers! Right. Now, I'm gonna have to ask your old ladies to leave. This is for a men only. Now, just because Bubba's killer is still on the loose doesn't mean they won't be safe. Ladies, you brought your guns, right?
Yeah, Pop, come on. We only have this hall rented for from like 2 to 2:30, so.
Yeah, we're coming.
Almost there.
What a guy. Recover Cassie too.
Oh, boy.
Hot dog. Well, happy birthday, girl.
Yes. We remember the day you were born. It was April 20, 1950.
Not even close. What did you bring me?
Rest of my life.
you know Brittany used to wear headgear? It's true. Her teeth were so crooked that we used to call her our little Carney.
And there was this one time on Christmas when she was 5.
No!
She wanted this Barbie doll so badly.
Don't you dare! It's all she can talk about for weeks and weeks.
And finally, that Christmas morning,
if you go any further, I will hire a lawyer and become an antiquated minor. I swear on my life!
She opened her present from Santa, and there was that Barbie.
And that's it! That's the end of the story, everyone! Thank you for coming!
She was so excited when she saw the Barbie bag!
She beat herself!
And that's why we call her Freaky Pants!
Enough!
forgot.
My mom tried to play it off and pull and put a candle in the meatloaf. I vowed from that day on that I would not be like my mother and that I would try to connect with my daughter in every way possible. But it's like we don't even speak the same language.
You just don't understand me.
That's because you never want to talk to me.
Oh, I want to talk. You're just so busy lecturing.
That's not true.
And we have nothing in common. Sometimes I wonder if I'm adopted.
Oh, you are not adopted. Whether you like it or not, believe me. I had morning sickness with you for 6 months. I was miserable.
Oh, so now you're blaming that on me too? Like in the womb, I was already trying to get on your nerves.
That's not what I said. You're adopted. You practically look like twins.
Just because you still dress like you're trying to be a teenager does not make us twins.
I have a sense of style, young lady. That's not the point. How could you think that we don't look anything alike? We have the same ears.
Thanks a lot for that attribute. Giant Dumbo ear.
That's it. Go to your room. You're grounded.
Oh, you mean the place where I have my cell phone, iPod, DVD player, TV, and Xbox? Glad.
Oh, wait, I changed my mind.
I'm shocked.
Go to the basement.
What? Why?
You're being punished. Go to the basement.
But there's nothing down there but old moldy boxes, and it smells like mouse poop.
That's the point. I want you to think about what you've done.
But I haven't done anything.
You've been disrespectful. Go.
How long do I have to
stay? Until I come and get you now, move it, Missy.
I cannot wait until I turn 18. And then look out, world, I am so out of here.
She's going to be 18 before I know it. I just want her to be ready to face the world.
It all started this afternoon when she turned into this rabid she-beast and was like, you cannot leave this house to meet your scum of a boyfriend until you click every square inch of your room.
It all started this afternoon when I brought her some clean sheets. I suggested that it would be nice of her to make her bed before going out to the movies with her boyfriend, Todd. And I knew she'd be getting back late. She wouldn't want to make her bed in the middle of the night.
And she hates my boyfriend, Todd. She is always picking on his appearance.
Her boyfriend, Todd, is lovely. And he's a real gentleman. And last time he had just gotten a new haircut, and I made sure to point him out on that one.
So when I told her I wasn't going to clean my room, she blew up.
I couldn't understand why she didn't want to make her bed. I calmly explained to her that it only takes 5 minutes. Besides, I had done the hard part. I did the sheets. I do all of her laundry.
She's always doing things for me and then throwing it back in my face. Like the laundry. I could do my own laundry, but she doesn't trust me.
I like to do the laundry because she doesn't listen to my instructions. One time, she threw a red sweater into a load of whites. I had just gotten my husband 3 new packages of underwear. They all turned pink.
Just because Dad's tidy whities turned pink once when I was 12, she won't let me near her precious washing machine.
And I begged my husband, just throw them away. And he said, no, that would be a waste of money. He started wearing them. Oh, I pray every day that he doesn't get into a car accident. Because if the paramedics find him in pink underwear, I would be so embarrassed.
You know, frankly, I think she likes doing the laundry. It gives her something to do. I mean, without it, what would she have? She's a housewife. That's not a job.
I cook. I clean. I pay the bills. I garden. I go to the grocery store. I take the children to and from wherever they want to go, be it plays, dances, or sports. I change my own oil. I do all of the dishes and all of the laundry. I'm the nurse when they scrape their knee. I'm the plumber when the toilet gets backed up. I'm the technical support when the internet goes down or the satellite dish starts malfunctioning. I'm the delivery service when they forget to take their lunch or their homework to school. Being a mom of 2 high schoolers is a full-time job.
Why did she even have me if I'm such a burden?
My family is my life, and I know it's a lot of work, but I love being a mother.
And she is such a prude. I go out of my way to dress nice every Sunday when we go to church, and then she wraps me up in a coat, even in the middle of summer.
And I'm sorry, but the Lord does not want to see your cleavage, your thong, or your belly button.
And it's not
on buying clothes in size 0, and occasionally size 2. But how can someone be a size 0? Doesn't that make you invisible?
And don't get me started on that tattoo I got. I am only 16, but the guy at the shop didn't even ask me my age. And besides, it's just a tiny flower on my lower back. You can barely see it. But when I came home, I could feel her eyes burning through me. This is my body. Just because she doesn't like tattoos and thinks that they're ugly does not mean I have to be just like her. I've had it for over 6 months now, and she refuses to even acknowledge it. It's like she doesn't even care.
Well, thankfully, she hasn't gotten any tattoos. I mean, yet. I got one when I was her age. It's on my lower back, so thankfully my shirt covers it. What was I thinking getting a tattoo of Devo? How did I think that family was going to be timeless? Anyways, she'll turn 18 soon enough. And when she turns 18, she can get a tattoo. It's her body. She can do with it what she wants. I'll still love her. It won't change a thing. Besides, it's just a tattoo.
We are totally different.
We don't seem to agree on anything.
Her idea of fun is staying with fabric softener, works the rest.
Her idea of fun is texting 1,000 times a day. Oh, I tell you, that girl could have written War and Peace just in the last week. Thankfully, we have the unlimited plan.
I'm telling you, we have nothing in common.
She never wants to hear me out. She always walks away.
She never lets me speak my mind. I never have a say. She comes. them really made her mad. I guess I'll see what's in one of these old boxes. I can't believe this. It's my mother's diary. Dear diary,
today I got my first tattoo, and I'm only 16 years old.
My parents hate it.
But I know that my favorite fan will always be
who the heck is Diva?
Excited?
like in the way they behave. I wasn't talking about... You know, can we just get back to watching the game?
No, we can't. Your mother made me promise you that I would have the talk.
What's the talk?
You know, the talk.
Putting air quotes on it doesn't make it any clearer. What are you trying to say?
Okay, you see, son, when one fluffy cloud from one side of the sky sees another fluffy cloud from the other side of the sky, they spark. We call that lightning.
Are you taking a new medication or something? Dad, look, I'm not even dating anyone. You've got nothing to worry about. I took a class on all that stuff. I've got all the info I need.
But did they tell you about...
If I have a question, I'll just ask.
Good.
Fine.
I'm glad we could have the talk.
That wasn't
the talk,
but I don't need
the talk
because there's nothing to talk about.
If I had a nickel for every time I've seen someone as beautiful as you, I'd have 5 cents.
What did you just say to me?
Do you believe in love at first sight? Or should I walk by again?
You are not teaching me how to pick up a girl!
You think I have my library card? Why? Because I'm totally checking you out.
Stop it now!
Hey, I'm telling you! Ladies love a good pickup line! I've got a million of them. I just wanted to show this rose how incredibly beautiful you are.
How you ever got mom to date you, let alone marry you, is totally beyond me.
She couldn't resist Le Tigre.
Le what?
Le Tigre.
What the heck is that?
It's what they used to call me in high school.
Oh, no. No, it isn't. There is no way that anyone called you that.
I was a predator. And the ladies were my prey.
I just wanted to watch the game.
Yes. Tiger in the jungle is a much better analogy. I should have started off with this. You see, son, like a tiger, you've got the claws, you know. You've got the power. But with that power comes great responsibility.
And now you're quoting Spider-Man.
I can picture it like it was yesterday.
Guess what? They changed it so you and I are together.
Then how about a date? Let's eat bread.
You see, son, hit me once, bum. Hit me twice, bum, bum. Hit me nine times, bum, 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 bum.
Things could have been better. Family. riding in this car, she won't make it very far unless she gets to pee.
Unless she gets to pee!
Why are we stopping?
Gas.
Honey, we just got gas last
night. We need gas.
I bet they have a bathroom inside!
And snacks!
And maybe even some headphones!
Hooray!
Mom, I love you. And, we have some money.
Whoa, 40 bucks? Thanks, Dad.
Honey, $40?
You and I are going to have a nice vacation all to ourselves. Wisely, they'll have enough money for a taxi cab home. Otherwise, they have a long way to walk.
Oh, honey, you're coming back!
But already?
Just drive!
Like them or not.
wife, and I picked a hot one.
And I didn't want to live my life alone.
Excuse me?
You
can pick your friends, but you can't pick your family, so you might as well be happy with what you got. Oh, you can pick your friends, but you can't pick your family, so you're stuck, whether you like them or not.
Awkward conversations with my dad about some girls and going to the wrong funeral.
Oh!
Watching Gramps and Grandma pop, drop, and lock. Sometimes family makes me want to hurl. But I'm stuck with you, so.
You can pick your friends, but you can't pick your family, so you might as well be happy with what you got.
Marcy!